Boy George joins me now. You see, school discotheque, there I was doing the shawaddy waddy moves and all kinds of that music. Fantastic.
We've all done it, Might have did it to Sweet and Slade, but...
Now, look, before we get underway here, phone call in, please wish Boy George a belated happy birthday for last Wednesday, Stuart and Ali Middleton from Aberdeen.
They're about 3 weeks too late, but thank you anyway.
3 weeks, but you see, they
June
knew...
June 14th.
You see, they'll be delighted, like my good self, that you're back together.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you don't look so delighted then, not in your head.
We've been back together for about a year and a half now, so it's kind of old news for us. It's like business as usual.
I know, but why? Why did you want to come back together?
Well, I don't think any of us wanted to. I mean, I think if we'd thought about it, we wouldn't have done it. It was just that we were approached by someone in America to do a documentary, and then that kind of got the ball rolling. But I think if we'd actually sat down and discussed it as a possibility, it never would have happened.
Are you amazed, George, that there's still a demand? I don't mean this in a derogatory way, but... Is it a pleasant surprise that there is a demand for the music?
I think it really boils down to whether people like the noise you make and the songs that you put out. I mean, I've had an up-and-down career. You know, I had the hits with Culture Club, and then I had a sort of a lull, and then I had a few solo hits. I think it really boils down to the song and the timing. It's all a question of timing.
Mm. Is there anything that you think... you're not going to do this time that you did last time?
Well, I think this time it's about enjoying it. You know, at the beginning of my career, I was a little bit uptight. And I think as you get older and you've done all that routine of being a diva and being demanding, you sort of get to the point where you think, well, actually, this is quite a good life and I'd like to have fun. Yeah. Enjoy it.
I tell you what, I always, and I still do love your makeup. It's a really, like, wake-up makeup, isn't it? Getting you up
especially
in the morning.
This time in the morning, yeah. It's not good.
Most women would be envious of the way you can do that eyebrow, eyelash, whatever it's called, eyelid stuff.
I have to make a confession. My friend Sarah did it this morning, but I can do it myself.
And you wrote your book, Take It Like a Man, which I believe the BBC are making into a film.
Yeah, it's been going on now for about 6 years, so I don't know when it will ever start, but... sometime this year or after the millennium, possibly.
Do you fancy taking part in a fancy playing yourself?
I wouldn't mind doing a sort of walk-on role as somebody else. I think that might be fun, but I don't think I want to play me. I mean, I did that already and did a very lousy job, so I'd like to let someone else get on with it, someone who can act.
And you're DJing, because up in, I don't know, Cream in Liverpool or other clubs across the country, and you're up in Liverpool doing a radio station as well. Is that, you still going to stay doing that?
Yeah, DJing's like my weekend job and Culture Club's my sort of day job. So I like the choice of doing the both things. It's really good fun.
And when you travel around the country, George, I mean, do you have a container lorry or a trailer to carry the hats?
A Winnebago.
On their own? I mean, do they go separately?
When I DJ, I don't dress up quite as much as when I do Culture Club, because it's very sweaty in those clubs.
The makeup would smudge.
Yeah, I mean, it depends. If it's a big event, then I'll slap a bit of makeup on. But if it's just a normal DJing gig, I just tend to sort of dress down a bit and
good.
Hide.
Well, welcome back, George. Enjoy it. Enjoy it with the rest of the band, because you're singing for us right after the break, yeah?
Yes.
New one?
New single.
Your Kisses Are Charity, and it's out next Monday, I think, 26th.
Yeah, 26th.
26th, good. And you'll be singing that later.
Night, you breathe the deepest sigh, turned away with those cold, cruel eyes. You said, won't you give me space to breathe? But my tears gave the confidence to leave. Now you say, I'm just too much for you. Today you were my brightest star, but even when you're near, I don't know where you are. I was wrong to show my weaker side. Now it's much too late to cry, cry, cry. I was blind to put my trust in you. If you leave me, I'll fall apart. Did you plan to make a fool out of me from the start?
Boy George, Culture Club there.
And just a quickie, John, who's on the drums there, his baby boy
John
is
on the drums.
Two today, Clyde is two.
That's John there. There's John there. Yes, thank you, John. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed.
It's good.
Thank you.
I like the one that you had out last year as well. Really, really catchy. I wouldn't sing it because I wouldn't offend you. It would not be nice to do that.
That's all right.
So what's it like second time around? Is it good fun?
It is good fun, yeah. I mean, we're able to sort of all enjoy it a bit more now, you know, and sort of not take it too seriously. I mean, obviously in the early days it sort of consumed every waking hour, but it's more of a sort of pleasure these days.
Yeah, I bet it is. And it's been doing really, really well, because that's the last single did really well, the album did really well.
Yeah.
And I'm sure this one will too.
We hope so.
I'm sure it will, I'm sure it will. But it must be really good, though, you know, to sort of come back like that
it
and
is.
Know that the music is still there and people are still loving it.
It is good, but you always go through that sort of panic period whenever you make a record and then you get ready to release it, because there's so many channels and obstacles you have to go through to actually get it into the charts, so it's always a bit nerve-wracking.
Yeah, you forget about that. I mean, we just think, oh, you make a single and it suddenly becomes number one or whatever it does, but I suppose it's a lot more, it's a business, isn't it, and there's a lot more to it.
Also, you know, I mean, Radio 1 don't give us any airplay. They won't play anybody from the 80s.
It's crazy.
So, you know, you've got all these sort of, luckily now there's lots of other radio stations like Radio 2 and Capital and Heart that will play you, but
I'm listening to Radio 2 now.
They actually broke Culture
thing?
Club, you know.
I know that.
Diddy David Hamilton, God bless him, he actually was the first person to ever play a Culture Club record, and I've always loved him since.
But it's all right now. It's all right now. It's Radio 2. We don't mind.
We always thought Radio 2 was cool, though, you see, right from the beginning.
So everybody's caught up with you, so they have. Yeah. So it's been good fun. You've enjoyed it. It's great. And anything, when you're sort of, have you learned anything, do you think, now from the second time around? Are you more sort of in control of things than you were before?
To a certain degree. I mean, you know, you like to think that you're in charge, but obviously there's so many other people sort of running around doing things on your behalf. But I think the main thing I've learned is that, you know, the pop life is a charmed life, and, you know, sometimes it's over before it started, so you've got to squeeze every last drop of pleasure and enjoyment out of it.
I think that's a great philosophy. I mean, I was reading a piece that you wrote in the Express, wasn't it? Sunday Express yesterday, and it was exactly that.
Yeah.
You were saying just enjoy it, because, you know,
I was talking about Ricky Martin, because, you know, apparently he's a bit of a diva, but I mean, that sort of stuff is funny, because it makes you more interested in the artist, makes you want to know more about them. I mean, people like Madonna, for example, because she's such a diva, it sort of keeps you interested. You want to know what she's doing next, you know. And I'm as bad as the next person.
Yeah, oh yeah. Well,
I love a bit of gossip.
Yeah, absolutely, so do I.
Bummy magazine.
I know, it makes the world go down, that's for sure. But as well as doing the music, you have carved out a career as a writer. I mean, you do a lot of writing.
Yeah, I'll write for the Express on Sunday.
Good.
I've done
it's
it for about 2 years now, and I really enjoy it. I enjoy it particularly because I left school with no qualifications, so to be writing for a national newspaper is a bit of an achievement.
Good for you. Absolutely.
I'm sure it annoys my headmaster. I hope he's watching.
I think you probably did annoy your headmaster.
I did actually. Actually, after I left school and when I started Culture Club, there was a sort of debate in the Times, because he did an interview and discussed my school record.
Oh, yeah.
So there was this big hoo-ha about that. But I left school and they said, you'll never be anything. So it's quite nice to be.
Oh, it must be very nice.
It is nice.
Oh,
yeah.
It must be very, very nice indeed. And you know, we're watching all that couture stuff. You go to all these shows, don't you?
I was in Paris, yeah. I was doing the music for the Versace show, and it's great fun. I mean, you know, you just got to take it as a bit of fun, because a lot of people do take it very seriously and get really upset if they're not in the front row, and you hear people storming out, and it's very funny. But if you're sort of not involved in it,
if you can take a step out of
and
it,
you're watching it
nice.
As a sort of people watcher, it's great. Yeah. I mean, I was at Versace, Madonna was there, Prince, or the artist formerly known as Prince Squiggle, whatever he's called, he was there.
Actually out and about. I didn't think he I didn't think Spiggle came out. I thought Spiggle just stayed in his compound.
No, he was there with his new wife, and he was wearing lovely glittery outfit. He looked like Lisa Minnelli with a beard.
Oh, jeez. That conjures up a lovely image.
And I met him as well.
Did he speak?
He said he liked my earrings. That was the extent of our conversation.
I think that's a really deep relationship you've got there with him.
And I think we've got a future. I think a duet is on the cards.
He doesn't say very much at all. But you, I mean, look at your hats. They're brilliant in all of your style. I mean, do you take, when you get up in the morning, what do you say to yourself? How do I feel today and what shall
What's
I wear?
What's clean? What's clean? What did I wear the other day on TV? It comes a bit, you know, it gets a bit difficult if you're doing a lot of TV. Yeah. It gets a bit difficult if you're going to a lot of parties and you're wearing the same hat, you know, you've got to sort of decide.
That's very true.
Put things in mothballs for a few weeks and then bring them out again.
Exactly. But like I was saying, you know, you carved out the career doing the writing, also DJing. I mean,
yeah.
You've got a great career there. It's terrific.
Well, that's my sort of weekend job.
Yeah.
And, you know, I really enjoy doing that. I go all over the country. Do a lot of work in Scotland.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, it's good fun up there. They like raving up there.
Yeah, just a bit.
They're mad for it.
One or two small
In fact, shades. The last tour that we did, the best gig was Scotland. They were just so nutty. They literally sang every song. I wouldn't have had to bother singing. I could have just stood there all night with the mic out. I mean, they really got involved. It was good fun.
Do you like performing this time round better than when it first all happened? Are you better?
I think we're all better musicians, yeah. Mm. And I think, I mean, in the early days, I hated touring. I hated it. Because you're sort of thrown into it, you know, and it was something I'd never done before.
Sure.
And you lose your voice, you know, you get ill because you're doing so much travelling. But I think as you get older, you get more stamina. Mm. And you sort of know what to do when you go on stage. And plus, people know all the songs now.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's that familiarity, which really helps, you know, doing a live gig. It's great.
Well, it's a joy to see you as always. Good luck with the single.
Thank you.
To see you, George. Thank you very much indeed.